Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. Many of us are working to improve our diet in the new year, as we all do every January, and some of us even turning to a vegan lifestyle for some better health. So we brought in Charene Bradley. She's chef and owner of Vegan VYBEZ, and she's here with some tips on adding vegan items to your diet. Welcome for the first time.
Thank you.
We're so glad you're here.
Thanks for having me.
I think a lot of people are trying to do different things, but your tip is don't do it all at one time.
Don't overwhelm yourself by YouTubing and Googling different recipes. That can make it seem harder than it really is.
Sure, and I've been trying to do that for the last 3 days. We're only the first three days. But I tried a meatless like spaghetti sauce, and there were so many different recipes. I just didn't know where to begin, so I start with the easiest. But so what are some of your other tips?
My tip is just to keep it simple.
Okay.
Basically, the most common question people are always asking me is, well, what do you eat? I eat all of the things that I ate before. I just veganize everything.
Okay.
So the easiest way is to keep it simple by swapping out your meat with the plant-based protein.
Yeah.
For instance, today we're doing quesadillas.
Okay.
So in place of the steak, we'll use mushrooms.
And you could even do that for my spaghetti sauce.
Absolutely. I use diced mushrooms all the time for my meat sauces, like spaghetti and lasagna.
Okay, good. That sounds good. All right, so where do we begin with your quesadillas?
So we're going to start with...
I love these mitts. You said your son made these?
Yes.
These are so cool. All right, very fun. Did I just take yours?
No, you're fine.
Okay.
So we're going to start. I always use grapeseed oil or avocado oil. They're the healthier oils. So we'll just add a little to our skillet here.
Okay.
And we're going to start with our diced mushrooms. My favorite are... Baby Bella.
Okay.
Just get those going there.
Now, can we get all this already cut up?
Absolutely.
I noticed that cooking fresh, and you got to sit there and cut up a lot of stuff. This takes a lot of time.
Some chopped red pepper. And again, you can adjust this to put whatever you like in it.
Okay.
Some sliced red onions. You can use yellow onions, sweet onions, Spanish onions, whatever you like.
Okay.
But I prefer red onions.
And you were talking about meal prep as well.
Yes.
You can prep a lot of this the night before.
Yes.
I always
suggest having one day out of the week that you can prep all of your meals, and that way you don't have to worry about, sometimes it's not always convenient to grab lunch and dinner on the go.
Right.
So meal prepping is very important.
And especially if you're trying out some healthier ways, you can always find that out at the restaurants.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Okay, so we got the mushrooms and onions going. And we're gonna add in some diced tomatoes.
Okay. Are these drained or not drained?
No, they're not. You can use canned diced tomatoes, whatever's easiest for you.
All right.
We have some corn here. And again, whatever it is that you like to use.
Okay.
Some black beans. You can use any other beans you like. If you use refried beans, please make sure that you read the labels, because a lot of them have lard in them. So you want to make sure you read. When going vegan, one of the most important things is to read the labels on literally everything.
Now, why do people shy away from vegan? Obviously, they love their meat, but are they just scared to go that route? Or
I think most people...
It's becoming more popular, I feel, in the last several years.
It is. Most people are more knowledgeable on the health benefits of it. So more people want to go vegan. They just don't know where to start.
Okay.
Again, so I say keep it simple.
Don't be scared.
Don't be scared.
All right, so what are some of the seasonings?
We have some saźon.
Oh, what
is
tropical. That?
It is a Spanish blend, so you have some cumin, some paprika, some black pepper, garlic, a little bit of dried lime in there. We have some dried oregano.
Okay.
A little more cumin.
Can I help do
go,
something?
Sure.
Should I just, like, stir this? All right. Here we go.
And we don't use too much salt. Again, some more smoked paprika, just a little.
Okay. A little spicy.
Yes. Seasoned to taste.
Now, how long does this take on the stove?
That only takes about 5 to 6 minutes.
Okay.
Just until the mushrooms are tender.
Boy, that smells so good. You like how I'm using an oven mitt to stir? Just want to point that out. All right, so what's next?
So then from there,
we got about 45 seconds.
All right. So we just get...
Just going to take this off.
We're just gonna oil up our skillet here.
Okay. Extra virgin olive oil?
Extra virgin olive oil is okay. I prefer grapeseed oil or avocado oil.
Oh, you said that. Okay.
I did.
All right.
And you can use any type of tortilla you like. This is just a flour tortilla, but you can use whole wheat.
Okay.
And we're gonna layer some vegan cheese. There is a large variety of vegan cheeses out there. Don't be afraid. We're gonna add our mixture there, a couple teaspoons.
I'm gonna let you finish. Can I try this while you're finishing up?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, let me try this. This looks good.
Uh-oh. And you can top that with, we have some vegan sour cream, some mashed avocado.
Oh, this is excellent.
Thank you.
That
and again,
vegan
you
cheese
can,
is good.
Isn't it?
Is it's, that like a Mexican?
This is Daya cheddar.
Wow, this is really good. Really,
and
really good.
And just fold it over and you flip when both sides are golden brown.
Then you're great. This is excellent. The recipe
Thank
will
you.
Be on our website, fox8.com.
Yes.
It is not lacking flavor at all. You know, you
Thank
can
you.
Forgo the meat.
Very Absolutely.
Good. Thank you. You were awesome.
Thank
you have
you.
To come back.
I will, definitely.
Okay.